Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Now the other day we restored this old eMachines system to its former 2005 glory. I found it cheap and it just needed a few bits to get it working again. Today it's been overhauled once more and modernised a little bit, turning into something that could potentially be a more powerful and capable gaming system. But for now, it's an example of what can be done to an ageing PC if you do have a bit of a tighter budget. So let's take a look inside and talk about why you might want to do this before putting it to the test. Using a few spare bits, we've swapped out the old 478 motherboard for an 1151. Upgrading the motherboard was essential to give ourselves an upgrade path, and with socket 1150, you can find loads of used CPUs available at good prices. I decided to opt for an i3-4130 processor, which I found for just £32 on the used market, or just over $40. It has 2 cores, 4 threads, but most importantly HD 4400 graphics, which make for an okay stopgap while you're saving up for a discrete graphics card. There's also 4GB of DDR3 RAM inside. Dual channel is usually better, but it can be cheaper to buy a single stick, especially considering the rising memory prices at the moment. Thankfully, you can find 4GB of memory on the used market for around £10, with similar dollar-based prices. Some of you may think keeping it all in this old case looks a little ugly, and some of you may think, like me, that there's something cool about a sort of sleeper build that offers more power than you would assume it did just by looking at it. The cases on old pre-builts are often very solid too. This is extremely sturdy compared to a modern budget housing that would cost close to what I paid for this whole thing anyway. Plus, you also get the old bits to play around with. The hard drive has been swapped for a SATA one and features 250 gigs of storage space. Not lots, but at £6 I can't complain. Of course, the integrated graphics will leave a little bit to be desired, but the first priority was modernising our system, and I'll be adding a new PSU and graphics card later down the line. Let's see how it performs anyway in its current state. Starting off with Skyrim, 720p was the resolution we opted for here to guarantee the best experience with the HD 4400 graphics, and we saw an average of 31 frames per second. A vast improvement over anything we may have seen with the PC beforehand, even if this isn't the best gameplay experience. There really wasn't any stutter here, but it will be interesting to see what further improvements we'll get with a graphics card when we come to upgrade this a little bit more. Dirt 3 next, or what I like to call one of the most optimised games ever. It ran at 45 frames per second on average across 3 separate races, with the low settings at 720p once again. 1080p was also playable, but suffered from frame drops here and there, resulting in less than 30 frames per second on occasion. Nothing too bad, but 720p was the best way to play. CSGO with the low settings managed to stay at above 60 frames per second most of the time, with 63 on average. 1080p was achievable once again, but the frame rate did suffer, and at this resolution, it was pretty much a flawless experience. I tested the game for an hour across a few different maps, and this average was worked out by taking the average from across all of those combined. Ignore any stutter in the footage, as this wasn't present during gameplay. I then ran the benchmark in Tomb Raider at 720p once again with the low settings. The average came back at 42 frames per second, and during actual gameplay the result didn't differ too far from that, as I was getting between 30 and 50 most of the time with no significant frame drops. Turning things up to medium meant a drop to around 26, so it really wasn't playable like that. Finally, it was the turn of Dishonored, which ran quite well with 44 frames per second on average with the normal in-game settings. For light gaming, you can definitely have an acceptable experience with a system like this, but I will be upgrading it further at some point to turn it into a fully fledged, yet budget sleeper build. For now though, it did okay, and at least we've given this computer a new lease of life thanks to some more modern components. Let me know what further upgrades you'd like to see, leave a like or dislike on this video, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. Thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll see you all in the next one.